Hello Galactic Family. Welcome aboard. Gaia Planetary Station is happy that you like the messages and information we communicate. Help the channel to grow by subscribing, commenting on the video, sharing, becoming a member and donating to the channel. We always appreciate good energies and vibrations. We are together in this new era, ground crew, stay strong. Victory of Light. Hello Galactic Family, greeting and love, I am Mahatma, the Cosmic Logos, my energy stems across 352 levels and dimensions of the Creator's universe. I exist as an expression of all that is the Creator, I exist as an expression of every manifestation of the Creator. This means that we are the same. You and all that you create is born from the Mahatma energy. Mahatma is a synthesis, it is a oneness, a collection of energy and truth, it is the merged frequencies and vibrations of the Creator. Today, I Mahatma wish to bring forth communication to you focused upon light sequences. It is important currently to remember your oneness with all vibrations of light. There are numerous expressions of the Creator. Let us call each expression of light a light sequence as if it is a code or a sequence of numbers. Each light sequence is an expression of the Creator and the manifestation of the Creator. You yourself are a light sequence, you are a combination of light vibrations and within your being, there are many light sequences. It is important currently to bring the energy of oneness, wholeness, and completeness into everything, into every light sequence. This vibration of completeness, wholeness, and oneness is present within every light sequence, within every expression of light. Therefore, we are activating the remembrance of oneness with all that is the Creator within every light sequence, which means within your being, within your creations, within the reality around you and within everyone else, those that are visible to you and those that are not. We wish to reactivate, empower, and magnify the vibration of oneness. As the vibration of oneness magnifies within everything and everyone, it becomes like a magnet connecting and drawing all light sequences together to create one large expansive light sequence, creating the truth of the Creator. Let us imagine that every being upon the earth and the inner planes is formed of light. As we activate and magnify the light, so the light becomes a magnet drawing each person and being on the earth and the inner planes to connect. As they connect, their light synthesizes and merges, thus, we experience the Creator. As every being connects and merges their light, the Creator is reborn for every being and through every being. This means that if only for a moment or maybe even a second, every being upon the earth will have a Creator experience and remembrance, a realization that is unique to them. They will experience that they are an expression of the Creator, they radiate the Creator's light, as does everyone else, and that each being is a light sequence expressed from the Creator. All beings are the same, born from the Creator into unique creative expressions. Imagine for a moment that every person on the earth and the inner planes had this realization, even if it was only for a moment or a second, and then they forgot it once more. The second of remembrance would create a spark, a charge of light, that would flow throughout their physical beings, throughout their reality. It would touch everything that they think of, everything they create. It would touch you, all aspects of your being and your reality. Thus, upgrading the physical body, the energy bodies, the reality, upgrading the connections with each being. It is akin to a software upgrade, making it easier for each being to connect with the Creator and to connect with the Creator in each other. Even if they forget the upgrade after it happens, the remnants of light would remain etched into their cells, into their energy systems and chakras. Like wisdom that is lingering or a light that is glowing and will continue to heal, continue to work, Continue to invite more of those moments of connection, activation, and remembrance of the Creator. Those sparks, seconds, and moments where every being connects, remembering themselves as the Creator and each other as the Creator, will become more frequent. The charge of light within their beings, in your being, will build light sequences, will develop and will progress. More and more light will enter into your being and your expression of light will be so much more powerful. You are a being created by light frequencies and light codes. As these codes transform, advance, and develop, this encourages others to as well. The more frequently this happens, the more everyone recognizes themselves as a sequence of light vibrations from the Creator, like a sequence of qualities or codes from the Creator. They will begin to recognize themselves as light more fully and be able to enter the space of that light to discover its wisdom, its coding, its impact, and to realize that moment of connection with self, with the Creator and all beings is the moment of truth. With this realization, it will be as if the veils are lifted, maybe gradually, and you will begin to recognize everything as light, light sequences. Another way of explaining it is as if you are recognizing everyone as sounds, as if everyone has their own sound of light or their own song of light. We encourage this activation to take place. It supports you in recognizing that everywhere outside of you and inside of you there are light sequences. These light sequences create material matter, they create thoughts, emotions, and experiences. It is like imagining everything has a DNA that is composed of light. When you recognize this, you realize that the vibration of light essential to connect with is oneness, connection, completion, and wholeness. As you align yourself with the light sequences from Mahatma of oneness and synthesized light, you will align all your light sequences with oneness energy. As you focus upon this within your being, you know that others will be achieving the same around the world. You can ask your soul to connect with these souls to share and exchange the vibration of oneness, thus empowering your light frequencies and light sequences, empowering the vibration of oneness. Each time you experience this, you may have a moment where you are in complete bliss, complete connection with the Creator, with yourself, and with others. It may be simply a glimpse, but the more you achieve it, the more you will experience the oneness, the Mahatma energy, the more people will gather to experience it with you. When you connect on a soul level, you will feel the power growing each time you experience it. Then you will realize that these moments of connection happen in your reality as well. The more you notice them, the more apparent they will be. The more you will create them until you can spend a good length of time in that energy of oneness and connection. You will know that there is a shift happening upon the earth because you will be able to spend a greater length of time in oneness and connection with all that is the Creator. This is a sign that others are doing the same, creating the same shifts. The more people are gathering in oneness, the more impacted the earth and all beings. This process will be immensely clearing. It can clear baggage from your energy systems, very easily and quickly. I encourage you to contemplate this, to call upon my energies Mahatma, and to experience your connection with the Creator and all that is the Creator, as well as light sequences. In your own time, you may wish to ask to investigate your own light sequence. You may see, sense, acknowledge colors or sensations, coding or sounds. This can be very insightful into your own vibration and unique expression. To me, the season of light begins as November comes out of her multicolored cocoon, stretching her wings of light to become the beautiful season of love. As the light begins her descent upon the planet Earth, we enter the true season of love. A season born of timeless miracles, myths and magic, a season of light that seeks to be embraced in the hearts of all humans. It asks humans to stop making excuses as to why one does not celebrate what is holy, what is good, what is a gift. life has become virtually gridded, creating a separation far from the one heart. Too many reasons not to love or not to give, not to believe. The season of light is thick with promises, filled with free-formed miracles. Miracles that take form and actively seek vessels to gift. The number 11211 was issued to Earth in 1992 as a beginning light activation. It is a doorway, a gateway into your greatest potential as a human. This activation number asks you to seek divine memory. The one seeks itself through a mirror reflection. This 11211 doorway offers an opportunity to surpass all limitations you have unknowingly set for yourself and others, to clear the slates of your heart and soul. One to one, we enter the oneness we all share in common. 11211 descends upon the earth like the spirit of a dove that lands softly in the hearts of mankind. As the 11211 energies are birthed, let them purge you of what has been solidified and blocked. All of heaven known and unknown enters through this gateway. Align with all you know to be love. A flooding of the heart allows you to rise above previous emotional tide lines, removing the barnacles of the past. Holiness goes beyond religion and sacred teachings. It lives deep in the bones of every human on earth, for it is through the very breath of holiness that earth is alive. Humanity has virtually lost part of their heart. It is easier to touch an emoji than to touch the wounded hearts of others. Like a training pigeon, they swipe through the air with the greatest of ease, hoping their heart-filled characters will land in the cloud somewhere. 11211 is a powerful number initiation sequence. It signals to the light sequence within that it is time to wake up and smell the cold brew coffee. Each time that you see 11211 on a clock, a license plate or a grocery receipt, you are being given an opportunity to walk into a gateway of instant manifestation. The universe has just taken a snapshot of your thoughts, which are manifesting into the physical realm per your thoughts. Every time I see 11:11 inches any form, I stop instantly and align with the light and the thought that needs to be birthed. 11:11 is the number of light masters. It is an encoded light structure of remembrance. Life and daylight shortens itself like a dog on a lead, as the 24 hours of Earth time now shifts into a denser mode, demanding more than before. Many possibilities come, invisible of nature, camouflaged like a hunter in the fall leaves. The heart demands complete opening in this powerful season of light. The Christ heart within humanity awakens with a holy dialogue. The light that comes is thick like a mist that actually has a shadow. The shadow dance comes to teach and redefine its light. This living 11:11 light comes to soften our shadow edges, sculpting and honing us, polishing us, asking us to shine brighter and more often. This holy season asks you to stand up for light, to escort miracles down your street, to have lunch with the angels. The greatest transition from solid form into light form is indeed a transition from the dense physicality of the old 3D, into the higher light body form of the 5D and higher. The higher your vibrational frequency, the less dense your body becomes. And the less you become attached to physical form. I was most surprised and indeed humbled yesterday, when I had a reflexology session with a most enlightened lady, who indeed is pioneer light worker, when she told me that my whole body and systems is going through an intense transfiguration. She confirmed what my higher guides have told me time and again, especially escalating in immense ways since October, as I have now fully anchored in the white flame and have been working intensely with it. Indeed, my own life quest since 2004 has been to reconnect with the Crystal Pyramid Temple of the White Flame, and indeed to reactivate the Crystal Pyramid Temples and the crystalline energy grids with the spinal column of myself, others, and the Earth. If you have read my book, Why I Was Born in Africa, the previously unrecorded history of Elysium and the Lion Kingdom, you will know what I'm talking about and how I had to take immense leaps of faith, following my highest guidance and trusting it. Now all is coming together in miraculous ways. I am understanding more and more what is meant in the Bible when Yeshua said that it is easier for a camel to get through eye of a needle than for certain souls to get through the portals of ascension. Mainly because most who live on planet Earth fear of delving deeply into themselves for answers, for healing, and indeed for the dissolving of the patterning of pain and suffering, accumulated over many lifetimes. All paths lead within, for the kingdom of He is indeed within you. It is not outside of you. As you indeed ascend, you step more and more in the truth of who and what you in truth are, and indeed, allow the wounds to cleaved open, the pus to be let out, so that you can finally be freed from those patterns of suffering and pain and indeed free others as well. The freer you become, the more you grow in universal Christ consciousness and indeed into embracing the fullness of the divinity which lives within you. Your own soul as one with the divine in all that is. Thus indeed transfiguration, in truth means resurrection, and a complete dying of the old, and then metamorphosis into the light body and indeed into mastery and illumination from deep within. The more I am experiencing this, the more insight and understanding come. It is something one needs to experience firsthand, and each one of you will experience it differently and to the degree that you are ready for this. Your own free will and choice, in the end, determines the outcome. You can choose to ascend, or not to ascend. All of life is never a destination but rather an evolutionary journey of discovery for the soul. Greeting and love, I am Mahatma, the Cosmic Logos. My energy stems across 352 levels and dimensions of the Creator's universe. I exist as an expression of all that is the Creator. I exist as an expression of every manifestation of the Creator. This means that we are the same. You and all that you create is born from the Mahatma energy. Mahatma is a synthesis, it is a oneness, a collection of energy and truth, it is the merged frequencies and vibrations of the Creator. Today, I Mahatma wish to bring forth communication to you focused upon light sequences. It is important currently to remember your oneness with all vibrations of light. There are numerous expressions of the Creator. Let us call each expression of light, a light sequence, as if it is a code or a sequence of numbers. Each light sequence is an expression of the Creator and the manifestation of the Creator. You yourself are a light sequence, you are a combination of light vibrations, and within your being, there are many light sequences. It is important currently to bring the energy of oneness, wholeness, and completeness into everything, into every light sequence. This vibration of completeness, wholeness, and oneness is present within every light sequence, within every expression of light. Therefore, we are activating the remembrance of oneness with all that is the Creator within every light sequence, which means within your being, within your creations, within the reality around you and within everyone else, those that are visible to you and those that are not. We wish to reactivate, empower, and magnify the vibration of oneness. As the vibration of oneness magnifies within everything and everyone, it becomes like a magnet connecting and drawing all light sequences together to create one large expanse of light sequence, creating the truth of the Creator. Let us imagine that every being upon the earth and the inner planes is formed of light. As we activate and magnify the light, so the light becomes a magnet drawing each person and being on the earth and the inner planes to connect. As they connect, their light synthesizes and merges, thus, we experience the Creator. As every being connects and merges their light, the Creator is reborn for every being and through every being. This means that if only for a moment or maybe even a second, every being upon the earth will have a Creator experience and remembrance, a realization that is unique to them. They will experience that they are an expression of the Creator, they radiate the Creator's light, as does everyone else, and that each being is a light sequence expressed from the Creator. All beings are the same, born from the Creator into unique creative expressions. Imagine for a moment that every person on the earth and the inner planes had this realization, even if it was only for a moment or a second, and then they forgot it once more. The second of remembrance would create a spark, a charge of light, that would flow throughout their physical beings, throughout their reality. It would touch everything that they think of, everything they create. It would touch you, all aspects of your being and your reality, thus, upgrading the physical body, the energy bodies, the reality, upgrading the connections with each being. It is akin to a software upgrade, making it easier for each being to connect with the Creator and to connect with the Creator in each other. Even if they forget the upgrade after it happens, the remnants of light would remain etched into their cells, into their energy systems and chakras. Like wisdom that is lingering, or a light that is glowing and will continue to heal, continue to work, continue to invite more of those moments of connection, activation, and remembrance of the Creator. Those sparks, seconds, and moments where every being connects, remembering themselves as the Creator and each other as the Creator, will become more frequent. The charge of light within their beings, in your being, will build, light sequences will develop and will progress, more and more light will enter into your being, and your expression of light will be so much more powerful. You are a being created by light frequencies and light codes. As these codes transform, advance, and develop, this encourages others to as well. The more frequently this happens, the more everyone recognizes themselves as a sequence of light vibrations from the Creator, like a sequence of qualities or codes from the Creator. They will begin to recognize themselves as light more fully and be able to enter the space of that light to discover its wisdom, its coding, its impact, and to realize that moment of connection with self, with the Creator and all beings is the moment of truth. With this realization, it will be as if the veils are lifted, maybe gradually, and you will begin to recognize everything as light, light sequences. Another way of explaining it is as if you are recognizing everyone as sounds, as if everyone has their own sound of light or their own song of light. We encourage this activation to take place. It supports you in recognizing that everywhere outside of you and inside of you there are light sequences. These light sequences create material matter, they create thoughts, emotions, and experiences. It is like imagining everything has a DNA that is composed of light. When you recognize this, you realize that the vibration of light essential to connect with is oneness, connection, completion, and wholeness. As you align yourself with the light sequences from Mahatma of oneness and synthesized light, you will align all your light sequences with oneness energy. As you focus upon this within your being, you know that others will be achieving the same around the world. You can ask your soul to connect with these souls to share and exchange the vibration of oneness, thus empowering your light frequencies and light sequences, empowering the vibration of oneness. Each time you experience this, you may have a moment where you are in complete bliss, complete connection with the Creator, with yourself, and with others. It may be simply a glimpse, but the more you achieve it, the more you will experience the oneness, the Mahatma energy, the more people will gather to experience it with you. When you connect on a soul level, you will feel the power growing each time you experience it. Then you will realize that these moments of connection happen in your reality as well. The more you notice them, the more apparent they will be, the more you will create them until you can spend a good length of time in that energy of oneness and connection. You will know that there is a shift happening upon the earth, because you will be able to spend a greater length of time in oneness and connection with all that is the Creator. This is a sign that others are doing the same, creating the same shifts. The more people are gathering in oneness, the more impacted the earth and all beings. This process will be immensely clearing. It can clear baggage from your energy systems, very easily and quickly. I encourage you to contemplate this, to call upon my energies Mahatma, and to experience your connection with the Creator and all that is the Creator as well as light sequences. In your own time, you may wish to ask to investigate your own light sequence. You may see, sense, acknowledge colors or sensations, coding or sounds. This can be very insightful into your own vibration and unique expression. To me, the season of light begins as November comes out of her multicolored cocoon, stretching her wings of light to become the beautiful season of love. As the light begins her descent upon the planet Earth, we enter the true season of love. A season born of timeless miracles, myths and magic, a season of light that seeks to be embraced in the hearts of all humans. It asks humans to stop making excuses as to why one does not celebrate what is holy, what is good, what is a gift. Life has become virtually gridded, creating a separation far from the one heart. Too many reasons not to love or not to give, not to believe. The season of light is thick with promises, filled with free-formed miracles. Miracles that take form and actively seek vessels to gift. The number 11-11 was issued to Earth in 1992 as a beginning light activation. It is a doorway, a gateway into your greatest potential as a human. This activation number asks you to seek divine memory. The one seeks itself through a mirror reflection. This 11-11 doorway offers an opportunity to surpass all limitations you have unknowingly set for yourself and others, to clear the slates of your heart and soul. One-to-one-to-one we enter the oneness we all share in common. 11-11 descends upon the earth like the spirit of a dove that lands softly in the hearts of mankind. As the 11-11 energies are birthed, let them purge you of what has been solidified and blocked. All of heaven known and unknown enters through this gateway. Align with all you know to be love. A flooding of the heart allows you to rise above previous emotional tide lines, removing the barnacles of the past. Holiness goes beyond religion and sacred teachings. It lives deep in the bones of every human on Earth, for it is through the very breath of holiness that Earth is alive. Humanity has virtually lost part of their heart. It is easier to touch an emoji than to touch the wounded hearts of others. Like a training pigeon, they swipe through the air with the greatest of ease, hoping their heart-filled characters will land in the cloud somewhere. 11-11 is a powerful number initiation sequence. It signals to the light sequence within that it is time to wake up and smell the cold brew coffee. Each time that you see 11-11 on a clock, a license plate or a grocery receipt, you are being given an opportunity to walk into a gateway of instant manifestation. The universe has just taken a snapshot of your thoughts, which are manifesting into the physical realm per your thoughts. Every time I see 11-11 inches any form, I stop instantly and align with the light and the thought that needs to be birthed. 11-11 is the number of light masters. It is an encoded light structure of remembrance. Life and daylight shortens itself like a dog on a lead, as the 24 hours of Earth time now shifts into a denser mode, demanding more than before. Many possibilities come. Invisible of nature, camouflaged like a hunter in the fall leaves. The heart demands complete opening in this powerful season of light. The Christ heart within humanity awakens with a holy dialogue. The light that comes is thick like a mist that actually has a shadow. The shadow dance comes to teach and redefine its light. This living 11-11 light comes to soften our shadow edges, sculpting and honing us, polishing us, asking us to shine brighter and more often. This holy season asks you to stand up for light, to escort miracles down your street, to have lunch with the angels. The greatest transition from solid form into light form is indeed a transition from the dense physicality of the old 3D, into the higher light body form of the 5D and higher. The higher your vibrational frequency, the less dense your body becomes. And the less you become attached to physical form. I was most surprised and indeed humbled yesterday, when I had a reflexology session, with a most enlightened lady, who indeed is pioneer light worker, when she told me, that my whole body and systems is going through an intense transfiguration. She confirmed what my higher guides have told me time and again, especially escalating in immense ways since October, as I have now fully anchored in the white flame and have been working intensely with it. Indeed, my own life quest since 2004, has been to reconnect with the Crystal Pyramid Temple of the White Flame and indeed to reactivate the Crystal Pyramid Temples and the crystalline energy grids, with the spinal column of myself, others and the Earth. If you have read my book, Why I Was Born in Africa, The Previously Unrecorded History of Elysium and the Lion Kingdom, you will know what I'm talking about and how I had to take immense leaps of faith, following my highest guidance and trusting it. Now all is coming together in miraculous ways. I am understanding more and more what is meant in the Bible when Yeshua said that it is easier for a camel to get through the eye of a needle than for certain souls to get through the portals of ascension. Mainly because most who live on planet Earth fear of delving deeply into themselves for answers, for healing, and indeed for the dissolving of the patterning of pain and suffering, accumulated over many lifetimes. All paths lead within, for the kingdom of He is indeed within you. It is not outside of you. As you indeed ascend, you step more and more in the truth of who and what you in truth are, and indeed, allow the wounds to cleave open, the pus to be let out, so that you can finally be freed from those patterns of suffering and pain and indeed free others as well. The freer you become, the more you grow in universal Christ consciousness and indeed into embracing the fullness of the divinity which lives within you, your own soul as one with the divine and all that is. Thus indeed transfiguration, in truth means resurrection, and a complete dying of the old, and then metamorphosis into the light body and indeed into mastery and illumination from deep within. The more I am experiencing this, the more insight and understanding come. It is something one needs to experience firsthand, and each one of you will experience is differently and to the degree that you are ready for this. Your own free will and choice, in the end determines the outcome. You can choose to ascend, or not to ascend. All of life is never a destination but rather an evolutionary journey of discovery for the soul. Hello Galactic Family. Hello to all who like Gaia Planetary Station, I would like to thank you for being together to learn and grow the light. Improving every step and knowing that the energies of light are making an incredible cleaning in the universe and planet Earth is the great jewelry of this monumental change. All who are connected with their higher self must follow their own missions. Here I present some of the products of the store. Search to see if you like something. For those who want to make donations to the channel by PayPal, we have the donation link to the channel. Subscribe to the channel, be a channel member, always comment on the videos and click on like button. Thank you for the amazing messages, the fun conversations and participations in the chat of the videos. I am happy that many warriors of light are together in this new age. May 2021 be incredible for everyone.